Hi, I'm Kevin Lewis. Welcome back to our masterclass on data governance from AWS. And so now I'd like to talk about sustaining the data governance program and improving it over time. And the way we want to do that is to embed data governance into the operating model of the company. So we can talk about the processes and procedures as it relates to data governance itself, but I think it's even more important to talk about how we institutionalize data governance by making it a part of the fabric of the organization. So we talked earlier about, of course, targeting business initiatives and aligning our data governance program to those initiatives. And that's all well and good, and it works very, very well. But how do we keep that going over time? Okay, so when we talk about aligning to business initiatives, a lot of times you have to find them, you have to jostle schedules, you have to figure out how to convince the leaders of those programs that you're there to help their program. And I call it, it's like running alongside a moving train and jumping on, because these things are already in motion and you've got to take your data governance program and align it to those initiatives that are already in motion. And at the beginning of a data governance program, there's really no choice. You have to do it that way. But rather than jumping onto a moving train, how can we catch the train at the station like a normal person? And so let's talk about how we do that. And the way to do that is to look for some very specific processes within your organization that you can attach data governance to make it a part of the fabric of the organization. So if we talk about aligning to business initiatives, well, where do those business initiatives come from? Where are they first created? And they're typically created through some kind of strategic planning process. So the company and different departments and business units within the organization typically have some kind of strategic planning process where executives will get together, they'll think about, what are the initiatives we want to do for the coming year or over the next 3 years. And ideally, you would have someone like a chief data officer participating directly in that strategic planning activity. So again, this is where we link data governance not only to data strategy, but through data strategy to the rest of the enterprise. And so the chief data officer within that strategic planning process is basically going to do a couple of things. Number one, that person is going to help the company brainstorm on new initiatives, because the chief data officer will have a good understanding of capabilities in the world of data and in analytics. And that information can be used to inspire new ideas as it comes to what business initiatives should we be working on. But then the second thing that the chief data officer would be involved in strategy development for is to observe the initiatives that emerge from that process. That way, as those initiatives emerge, then the chief data officer is going to make sure that the roadmap for overall data strategy, of which data governance is a part of that, is going to make sure that it's revised, and it's revised to target whichever business initiatives that the chief data officer feels is appropriate to align to. That way, you're not looking for the initiatives that are very far down the road already with their schedules and plans and what their architecture is going to look like in terms of data, but instead you're catching it at the very beginning so that you can evolve the plans for data right alongside the plans for those business initiatives. And therefore it becomes just a natural part of the way initiatives are born. And then it's a natural part of the way the data governance process evolves over time. So that's the strategic level. And then through that, there is always some funding process. We talked about making sure that you're aligned to funded business initiatives or initiatives that are very likely to be funded. So where is that funding process in your organization? Can you attach to that and have observability into that, where you see all of the proposed initiatives and projects that go through that, and then you find the opportunity for the data that they're going to need to be successful? And again, you create or refine your plans to support those with with the right data governance to make sure the data is in a condition necessary. You do not need all of the details, okay? A lot of times people will say, well, wait a minute, I don't know all of their data requirements. I don't know all of their, all the detailed data. Well, we haven't done the data profiling. We don't know where the challenges are. That's fine. You should plan your data governance program at the same level of detail as the plans there are for those initiatives. So for example, let's say somebody is proposing a pricing optimization initiative. That's it, that's all I know. Well, what do I know for sure I'm gonna need? I'm gonna need price history. I'm gonna need to know the impact of price history on sales and the impact that it has. I'm gonna need to know information about products, and I'm gonna need to have information not just about products, but by location and information about products as it relates to web presence and things like that. So, and I can even have discussions or have an understanding of the condition of our data to support it. Again, going back to the customer experience example, I know generally the condition of data across different business units. I may not know in detail, and I may not have the detailed statistics about that customer data through profiling yet, but I generally know if data across customer data across the different customer channels is coherent, linked, or not. And if it isn't, and I have an initiative that is being proposed and likely to be funded, then I can put something on the roadmap that has that scope, has that direction, even if I don't have the details. And as the requirements emerge in detail for those targeted initiatives, then I'm gonna detail out the plans to support it. So this is what I mean by making it a part of the fabric of the ecosystem of the organization. And going further with this, enterprise architecture. So this is another opportunity. So enterprise architecture generally is looking across projects to both serve them, with shared architecture, and also to contribute to a shared architecture. So there's a sort of a two-way interplay between the projects that leverage and also produce elements of the shared enterprise architecture. So what we want to make sure is that the enterprise architecture function has an enterprise data architecture. This is not just about, it's not just about standardizing on technology, which database to use under which circumstances, but it's also about ensuring that our data resources are being deployed in a way that are shared. So it's not just about which database to use for customer data, but it's also about that customer experience initiative coming along and both contributing to and leveraging a shared customer data resource. Again, not just because it's a good idea, but because we have a list of initiatives that can benefit from this process. So enterprise data architecture often has something along the lines of like an architecture review board or something that's gonna keep a close eye on projects as they evolve. And it's going to provide that oversight, and we want to make sure that data is a part of that architecture review board. Again, we're not creating something completely separate for data governance, but we're piggybacking on the set of processes that exists, and this is another example. And so the enterprise data architect is typically an IT role, so we've talked about the relationship between IT and the business. The enterprise data architecture role is typically a person in the overall IT enterprise architecture function. And it's not technically a direct part of the data governance program, but it is a linkage opportunity. So we talked about the need for business involvement in the IT partnership with the business for doing things like sharing data and integrating data across projects. So the enterprise data architecture function can have a relationship with the data governance program to provide, let's call it the political will, the observation of the major initiatives and the benefit that's going to be achieved. So it's not just a technician saying, hey, you guys ought to share data. Instead, it's a voice of the business saying, well, here are the initiatives that are in front of us. If we don't share data, this one, and this one are all going to have to manage the same customer data over and over and over again. And this is real life. This happens all the time because individual initiatives will in fact repeat a lot of the same work. So you have to work out that relationship between enterprise data architecture and the data governance program. And hence, by doing so, it's an IT business partnership. So let's go one level deeper and into projects, into project methodology. So most organizations have some kind of a standard approach to how they deploy data in projects, how they deploy solutions overall, and then perhaps specifically some set of standard tasks and activities for deploying data. And so now what we want to do is build right into the data deployment project lifecycle, into the methodology, all of those data management practices that we talked about. So it's not just about doing data profiling generally or building data quality rules. Why not put a standard task right into the data deployment methodology? And what you can do there is you can say, okay, here is where we do our data profiling. And the purpose of it is to examine the data for data quality issues. And there's many other benefits you can get out of data profiling. And then typically in the methodology, you'll have roles and responsibilities. So you can put the role of the data steward directly as a standard role for those tasks. So you can think across the entire lifecycle of all of those data management activities we talked about, whether it's security, regulatory compliance, data quality management, master data management, data cataloging. Why don't we do these things as a standard part of the project development? Here is where we do profiling. Here is where we develop our data quality rules. Here is where we catalog our data and so on. And here are the roles and responsibilities. It doesn't mean that every single project has to touch on every one of those things, but at least it's more of an opt-out approach. It's you're listing all of the standard activities that should at least be considered within any data deployment project. So you can see through this effort that we start from where initiatives are born, we follow it through how they're funded, and how there's governance already observing and helping and interacting with these projects. And then the detailed responsibilities as it relates to, and the supporting technology to implement data management practices within the scope of data deployment projects. This is the way we can make data governance a part of the fabric of the organization. So, and this is, again, one of those things where I had to discover this on my own. I did not read about this anywhere. And I remember in my early days when I was, first getting at the retailer I worked at, we were getting our data governance and our basically our overall data architecture and data strategy aligned to business initiatives around things like supply chain management and pricing and shelf space and all those things that I talked about. Well, what I realized was that I noticed that every year, everybody was asked to propose their projects. There were different business areas. There were liaisons within IT that partnered with executives in the business, and they would all propose their projects for consideration. And I just thought, well, what a great opportunity to look at everything that's being proposed. And I always used to think of, remember the game Concentration, where you'd pick up a card and it was something like this? I would look at all these projects that were proposed and go, oh, that one's going to need sales data. That one's going to need sales data. That one's going to need product data. That one's going to need product data. And then I would take all these commonalities and propose to support them in my own projects and work hard to make sure that that work was not scoped into those other projects. So when we talk about building a load-bearing wall, there's no better way to be a load-bearing wall than to literally de-scope the work out of those target projects, put them into a shared project that can serve multiple efforts. And we did this every year, and it got better and better. And we also built into the project methodology very specific tasks and roles. And the thing is, we didn't build them all at once, but every time a new capability was deployed, we got a new data quality tool capability or what have you, a data catalog capability and so on. A standard approach when we were acquiring and developing that capability was to take that capability and build it in to the various elements of the process where it made sense. So that way it's institutionalized as it's acquired and developed, and then it gets better and better over time.